Yes. Tell me about you.
I'm a graduate of Ahmad Brother University, Business Administration.
Okay.
2-1.
Sure. What year did you graduate?
2014.
2014.
Yes, sir.
What have you been doing since then?
I've been doing this.
You've been doing this? And how do you find it?
Very interesting. So I get to meet a lot of people, and they also offer their wealth of experience, give me ideas on how to push it forward. And okay. So far, that's all. So, added to my own ideas.
Okay.
I put together and pushed it and come to this day.
Okay. I can only wish you the very best. But I'm sure you have a word of advice for young ones, young graduates, who are still looking for jobs all over the place.
Now, you don't need to wait. Because I personally believe that you don't have to work in an office to be successful. You can do something on your own. And if you see that it is making a lot of sense, go for it, push for it, and you definitely get it. I'm not where I want to be yet. But I thank God that thus far, I'm here. And I want to keep pushing forward.
Let's have a look at your products.
Okay.
So tell us about it.
So this, you know,
I might see the label.
Okay. There's a label on this. So but this tiger nut.
Okay.
Yes. So these are the two brands I majorly specialize on.
Okay.
And my customers find them very rich and enjoyable.
Wow. Let's have a look at the number.
So welcome to the Golden Stories. This is Tasha Frost. And today I have here Miss Ruth. She's from Nigeria. And I believe she's somebody who can really inspire the youth out there. So today I have here once again, Miss Ruth. Welcome to TGS.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
You're welcome. So Miss Ruth, I want you to tell us a little bit about yourself. I have an understanding of where you come from and all that, but I want to know, first of all, where you live in Nigeria, and then maybe a little bit of a background story.
I'm Ruth. Like you said, my name is Ruth. I live in Lagos.
Okay.
Lagos, Nigeria. A graduate of Ahmadu Bello University.
Okay.
Graduated 2013. I said 14 in the video because there was strike in 2013, ASUU strike. So the graduation had to be moved to 2014. So I can rightly say 2013, 2014, I graduated with a 2-1 from Business Administration Department. Yeah. I'm from Kwara State. My dad is Kwara. My mom is Calabar, Efik to be precise.
So that's basically about 6 years now since graduation.
Yeah.
And from the video I found, you haven't necessarily secured a job or what any graduate will be looking for when they come out of school. Yeah. So how has it been basically since graduation?
Well, the truth is I didn't really expect much. Maybe that's why I was content with the way I was.
Right.
You know, though I wrote some tests, some of which I can remember are, what is it called? KPMG and Coca-Cola. I think there was one other. I can't remember.
Okay.
But these are the two I can remember clearly. I wrote those tests immediately after my service. One was during my service, that was the Coca-Cola. Then the KPMG was after my service. The Coca-Cola was after my service, the KPMG during my service. I had to leave my place of primary assignment to come and write that test in Lagos.
Okay.
So, and after writing, I was not, of course, I failed the test in their own words, and I was not granted access to the next level. So I just said, well, why not I just delve into a skill I already have. I used to be a makeup artist.
Okay.
Yeah, I used to do makeup. I've been doing it since I was in 200 level.
Okay.
And that was what was pushing me through school. Even during service, I was doing it, teaching, doing some minor jobs. So when I finished school, finished my service, got married, I was still doing it. I did it until 2018. The reason I stopped was because I was not getting, one, that satisfaction. Then two, people were not willing to pay my fee. And I'm somebody that believes in standards. I love standards a lot. So I always place standards in whatever I do. And that's what I applied to the makeup. I was like, people were coming, pricing me too low. So I said to myself, I can't continue wasting my time. And the patronage was not even that much.
Okay.
So why waste my time, go ahead and keep doing this? Let me just take a break. And then I stopped. And that was when I became, that was when I was really jobless.
Okay, for those who don't know her, she is the founder and the entrepreneur behind Ethli Naturals. I will link all that in the description box. So what came about that name, Ethli Naturals?
I just sat down and I thought, well, why not I do something else? One thing about me is that I've not mentioned this in all of the interviews I've been granted, is I love complex things, like things that are hard for people to do. I love to do it. Maybe because I have all the energy in the world, so I have the strength.
Okay.
So I love to do complex things. So I thought, instead of doing the simple things that people know how to do, why not I just do something complex? For example, kunu. There are a lot of people that it's been long they took kunu. Kunu is not something that is widely sold, except for the houses that sell it on the street. But then there are airlines that may want to take. But because of the hygiene, they are skeptical about buying from those houses. So why not like come up with that idea, clean it up, and let's see where it goes. So the idea struck. I stood up immediately. I didn't wait for like, okay, let me think about it. I didn't think about it. Immediately struck, I stood up from where I sat that day. And I went out, started discussing with one or two persons. Okay, do they sell this here? If I come, will they allow me to sell? And they're like, yeah, there's no problem. So immediately I left from doing my findings. I went straight to the market. I had just 2.5.
So I bought 500 naira.
Yeah, so I bought a few bottles, like 20 brand new bottles. Okay, that's the point. I just started with picking bottles. I bought new bottles. I bought the kunu stuff. Now, my idea was, like I said, do kunu. That was my original plan for my business. But then the next day, I came home, I prepared it. Although it had one or two issues, I asked my mom, how did they make it? She said, this is the way they make it. I said, okay, I was happy. And I went to do it. It didn't turn out well. Mind you, that was my first time ever doing kunu in my life. I've never done kunu before. So it didn't turn out well. I was devastated. I was crying. Have I not wasted my time? What do I do? You know, when they describe something to you, like this is the way it's supposed to appear, and you not do it, it doesn't appear that way. You feel you have failed. So that was the feeling I had. Hey, what do I do? So I called my mom back. She said, I should not worry. I should relax. I should do this, do that. I also called my sister. She said, okay, she has someone who does kunu. Let her call the person and find out, which she did. And she got back to me. Yeah, I should not worry. The advice was, don't worry. Just relax. Prepare it that way. And let's see. Next time you do it better. I said, no problem. I prepared it. The very next day, I took it out. That was 17 bottles I took out. I sold out those 17 bottles. I was happy. Wow, they like it. So it was that same day of my first day of going out, I met some people. So they were telling me, why don't you do this other thing? What do they call it? They were thinking. And I said, is it Tiger? They said, yes, that they take it. Why don't I do it? And I said, okay. Thank God I had prior knowledge.
Okay.
I used to make it at home. So I knew about the preservation and all. Going into it as a business was not a problem. So I said, all right, no problem. I prepared that one too. So the next time I came with my kunu, I had tiger nuts. So they said, book. I sold out again. So that was when I now made it a goal that if I go out, I must sell out. before I get back home. So that was not my goal. Go out, sell out, go out, sell out, go out, sell out. Although it's not that easy to sell out, especially when people don't know you. So people are skeptical about taking things into their body from somebody they don't know. I had to do a lot of convincing. Convince, convince, convince. And with God on my side, it was easy. Although it wasn't easy in the literal sense, but with God helping me, I found it quite easy. Then talking about the name, I initially had a name, but something held me back from using that name. I wanted to do Ruthie's Naturals. But then I said, it doesn't sound quite okay. Me, I like getting, so I said, no, let me relax. I'd already paid the man advance to do that sticker for me. I said, no. He was asking me how far off. I said, no, just wait. There's something holding me back. So I held back until I now thought, I have two sons. One is Ethan, the other one is Liam. He said, okay, what I'm selling is natural. It's from the earth. So here I have Ethan and I have Liam. So if I combine their names, that should give me Ethli. Good. So Ethli Naturals. So I came up with that name. Immediately, I executed that plan of bringing it to life. And that's where I have my sticker, my name, Ethli Naturals. Then that logo you see on my brand. So I did it. I felt good with myself. I loved it. I said, yes, that push that had me waiting was not for nothing. So when I did it, I think that was what was even bringing more customers to me. Like, oh, this product looks good. Let them try it. They try it. Oh, wow. It's not about the look. It tastes better than the look. So stuff like that. And this is where we are today.
Wow. So on the day when the interviewer met you on the road, I saw you more like street hawking. You weren't moving with a vehicle. You weren't moving with anything. You were just walking. So how would you describe that whole experience? Because I know for sure that day kind of changed a whole lot of things. That's when I know I saw it all. So like, tell me how you felt, how that experience was, and then how you felt after everything.
Since this COVID-19 pandemic began in Nigeria, let me start from the beginning. When I started selling from the early days, I used to sell 5 times a week, exclusive Wednesdays and Sundays.
Okay.
Now I broke down at a point. So I now said, let me do 4 days. I broke down again. Health wise, the job is to produce this thing, especially tiger nuts, is not for chicken minded persons. Yeah. Some may want to do it because of the money. Majority of people that do tiger, I'm saying it. I can say it in all of their presence. Except the ones that really know why they started. The majority of them is because of the money in it. But like I said, I'm someone that likes to do my things differently. And so, as I entered the business and I saw the love people had for it, and the way they love my own system of preparation, the taste, I said, okay, it now became a passion. I was like, okay, 5 days to 4 days, it now turned to 3 days. I started doing 3 days. So that 3 days, my body loved it and all. Now, when the pandemic started, I looked at it, I said, I have to reduce my exposure because that's basically the way I sell. I don't do supermarkets, I don't do malls. I sell myself. So majority of my customers, 90%, they will tell you they know her personally because we relate on a personal basis.
Yeah.
So I said, let me do 2 days. So I reduced my exposure, go out 1 day, stay indoors, another day, come back indoors. They've been asking me why. I said, there's COVID, so let me just do 2 days. And they're satisfied with it. So that Thursday was not my selling day.
But you went
there? Yeah, Salah was supposed to be on Friday.
Okay.
Said, let me go out now. Let me collect their money before they spend it finish on Friday. They will now come back the next week me, I will not see anything I collect. Let me go and sell on Thursday. That was the way I was pushed by whatever pushed me. But I know it's good God spirit that pushed me. I went out, I sold. I was done selling. I was coming out from where I usually go to sell. And the man saw me. He called me. He actually bought. So he bought from me and I turned my back. I was leaving him. He said, he was just looking at me. Even when I went to meet somebody else and I was selling to the person, he was just looking at me. I was just smiling. I said, he then said, can you take a video of my product and put online? I said, no problem. I didn't know he was talking about me. I thought it was the cooler because he was looking at the cooler. So I said, no problem. That's why I said, no problem. Maybe let him do the video of the cooler while I was busy attending to some customer by the side. Only for me to get back, I wanted to pick my cooler and roll it away from that place. And he said, just put the camera on my face. if you take a good look at the beginning of that video, you would have seen that I was laughing.
Yeah,
I was laughing. I thought it was a joke. But in a split second, I just realized, no, this man may not be joking. Let me get serious. That was when I removed my face mask and I started asking his questions. I didn't know it would become this deep. I never knew it would go this far. I was thinking, oh, he will put it. Yes, I know he's an actor, he's a presenter, he's a star. But I didn't know somebody else would pick it, another person would pick it, another person would pick it, and like thousands of persons now know me. So I went home that day, not expecting anything. I took the video, I was happy, I made a star, and I got to normal, nothing. I wasn't expecting it, so I just shut it out. That night, I started receiving calls from people abroad. They saw my video, some will pray for me, some will offer me financial help, some will patronize me. I have customers abroad who order in behalf of those at home.
Okay.
So they were just calling me, they saw my video, I said, okay, no problem. Not until the next morning. The next morning I woke up, I saw that when your body has carried it. I was like, this is not getting serious. How come? What is going on? I saw my followers, they started shooting up. I had 57 followers before I slept. When I woke up that morning, before I saw Moni's post, it was 250 something. After Moni's post, I started seeing
thousands.
1,000, 2,000, 10,000. I was like, what's going on? I didn't understand it. Before you know it, people have started calling me that I should adjust my setting on my account. Tunde Not has, he cannot mention me. A lot of people want to tag my page, but they can't tag. The calls kept coming. While I'm answering the call, another one is waiting. When I want to answer that one, another one is waiting. My phone was just buzzing. I was like, God, this is serious. It has become really serious. Others were coming. Although that part too, at first, we did not really handle it right. But thank God now we know better. We are handling it better. But it was just, it just came as a shock, a surprise. Something you were not ready for. I thought I was ready, but I was not ready. I wasn't ready. So it was overwhelming. I was really happy. Omoni tagging me, DJ Abbas, we have Tunde Ednot, and some other people. I met Mr. Dayo Adeniyi, and it's still a dream. I'm still finding it hard to believe, but yes, it's happening. Well, I'm happy that God has decided to showcase me with all the hard work, the pains, the persistence. It's paying off.
Wow. I don't know. I saw that. I think I was in bed when I saw that particular video from Omniobili, and I follow her. So it's like, you know, she's like, everybody gather here. Let's look at this video. I'm like, okay. And she really went out of her way that's what I really admired about the whole thing. The fact that she went out of her way to support you. She was like, no, I'm not letting this thing slide. I'm making sure she's getting the support she needs. And then I kept following your page. I'm like, let me look at this. 1 minute was like 15,000. The next one I woke up was like 19,000. I'm like, okay. Yeah. And then I was like, okay, let me just make sure I reach out. And I'm really grateful that you actually accepted to do this. So before, I know you're quite busy, you have a lot of orders and everything going on right now. It's understandable. So before we go, I want to make sure that the audience, you know, hear from you. Any advice you may have for them, because I know, especially in Ghana, which is where I come from originally, in Ghana, there are a lot of graduates out there who are finding it difficult to get jobs. Unemployment issue is difficult. It's a whole big issue, even in Nigeria, as I know. So I'm pretty sure a lot of people might see this and wonder, do I follow the same route, or do I also keep looking for jobs, or do I just give up? You know, because you could have easily gone for another kind of business. Okay, you could have gone for vacation, like maybe dressmaking or mechanic job, anything basically, but you chose to go for Kunu and Tiger Nut. So I don't know if you have anything you might tell a graduate out there who's in that kind of dilemma.
I mentioned earlier that I like complex things. That's my person.
Right.
Maybe because my dad is someone that does complex things too. Growing up in that kind of environment shaped me.
Right.
So it really has to do with the kind of person you are. If you are not that kind of person, don't do it. Don't do something for the money. I didn't do it for the money. If I did it for the money, I won't be here today. Mm. That's the truth. I'm saying it. Nobody may believe you. I know that is why. I do it now. It has become like a passion. If I don't go out in a week and see my customers, I don't feel happy. When they don't see me and I appear all of a sudden, they are all asking questions. Where did you go and hide? We've not seen you. You've abandoned us. You found other persons. Stuff like that. If you were doing it because of the money, you will not have that personal relationship with them. So if they see you, they don't care. They just buy and get out. They won't ask you. Some look for me. So most of them know my house. They come and buy. So do something that matches with your personality. A lot of people are calling me, disturbing me in my DM. I should give them a shout out, tag their page so that people will see them. I'm not a brand influencer. Even myself, I'm trying to promote my own brand. So for now, I am not doing that brand influencing. Maybe much later, when I've gotten a stable stance for my business, I know that I have the audience, everything is well set up. I can go into that. But for now, I can't be doing a shout out for you when I don't know if tomorrow you're going to start selling something else. So the point is, do something that has something to do with your kind of person. I love complex things. And so I decided on this vocation. Now it has become more than a vocation, but something that we're like, this 5 and 6, we're together. I'm thinking about production. Not just thinking about production, but let it remain the same quality, the same taste that people know. So that when they taste it somewhere, there are times that when I go out, people tell me, but not so much of times, but maybe like in out of 10 times, maybe 1 or 2 times, what happened today? Why is this thing like this? It's not like this before. What happened? Because they know how my brand tastes on a normal day. And so they can readily say, oh, there's a slight change. So the thing I do, I ask them, is it that bad? They say, no, it's not that bad. But you know, because we know your brand. So we know when there's that slight change in it. But the point is, I ask them, is the quality reduced? They say, no, well, there's just something that has changed. So that change, I always want it to be for the better and not for the worse. Yeah. So the days I get complaints of it being for the worse, I don't feel happy throughout. I don't feel happy because I'm not happy that they're not happy. So choose something that you can relate with as a person. If you're a tough person, can you do certain jobs that can accommodate that toughness? So don't be a tough person I'm going to be doing, where I'm going to be selling shoes. It won't work. Do something that at the end of the day, you can relate with it on a personal level.
Right.
So my advice to them is, don't copy somebody's business. Don't copy somebody's business. I hate copycats. People are also calling me and asking me, where did I see my cooler? They want to buy so that they can be moving around with it. Come on, guys. Just think outside the box. I didn't copy anybody. I did it with my own God-given sense. Apply your sense and you will see that it will work for you. You always have that mark of difference. The watch word is always strive to make a difference. That difference can be found within you. There's an attitude you have, there's a character you have, there's a God-given personality in you that you can use for a business and make it work. So that's what I did in my case. I can't advise you. If I give you that advice, I don't know you. So I tell them whenever they call, look for that person in you, look for that thing in you. Then choose the business that goes with it. You must not sell tiger nuts for you to be successful. It's not everybody that sells tiger nuts that is successful. So because I've sold it, I just blow all of a sudden. Does not mean when you sell it to you will blow. Don't go and harm yourself. Your body may not carry it. I am strong as a person, but you may not be a strong person. You may be soft. So there are jobs that require your softness. Why not look for that and work on it? Make a difference with it. And you will see that you will prosper in it. I did makeup. There are thousands of makeup artists out there. There are those that are excellent in it. For example, we have Beyonce. She's very good. She's perfect.
Yeah.
Then there are others that do. There are also others that are very good too. Yeah, it worked for them. There are others that sell tiger nuts like me. It worked for them. But the point is, Beyonce is different from them because there's a mark of difference in her touch. So I, as Ethli Naturals, there's a mark of difference I want to make in my own tiger nuts. Not the ones others are doing. No, I don't like general things. I have standards. So I have to live up to those standards. Those standards I'm applying to my product and my business. So just sit down, think about you. Who are you? What kind of person are you? What is your attitude? Do a business that goes with that. You excel, but don't forget, don't do it because somebody is doing it. Do it because it matches with your personality. And another important thing is, always think of something that will make your own be a different one from what others are doing. Yes, others may be doing. There's no business that is new in this life. No business is new. But your difference makes it new to them. Your own difference, your touch of difference is what will now make them attracted to you, to want to buy from you, to want to stay with you. There are certain things I've done that makes me that today, even if I leave one place, if I enter another place, I'll still get customers. There's something in me I would do. I know what to do. It's not about doing, you don't have to do bad things for you to succeed. There are so many good things you can do and make it in life. So make a difference, choose a business that has something in line with your personality, and don't forget, be diligent in it, be consistent, and pray. At the end of the day, if God doesn't support it, it may never work. So it takes God's support too, so that's just it.
Wow. Thank you so much. Thank you so much. I believe that people are going to really, really listen to you because this is something that people don't hear much or don't even get the opportunity to hear from people. So it's amazing, honestly. And I am even learning something because I try to do businesses on the side. So it's something to hear, definitely. So really, really, I appreciate you coming on today. I thank you for taking out time and I thank you for your words of wisdom as well.
No problem.
Thank you so much.
Thank you very much.
So You're welcome. You're welcome. So thank you guys for tuning in. If you guys want to follow Ethli Naturals, I'll put all her information in the description box. And please go support her. If you're in Nigeria, please go and find her. Wherever she is, contact her, order from her. I believe you'll love it. Maybe one day in the future, she'll be able to export it out to the US and to other countries as well. And then we also will get to taste it as well. Thank you so much. Thank you so much. And I'll see you guys in the next one.